Hello, everybody. Welcome to Greg's Beer Reviews today. Let's take a walk and go see what's in the fridge today. Hello, everybody. Thanks for stopping by Greg's Beer Reviews today. Looks like we got another one from Crooked Stave, and this is a collaboration beer. They've done this with Upslope Brewery. Says this is Ferris Fluxus, a wild Belgian pale ale at 8% ABV. And the only dating, it says volume 1 on this. And Nate sent me this, and he told me, he put a note on the bottle, this was a February 2014 release on this beer. And it was a brewed once beer with a collaboration with those two guys. It says Wild Belgian Ale right here, Wild Belgian Pale Ale, right on the front. So this one I'm pretty sure was done with the Brettanomyces yeast, like the one we did yesterday. But this one was just a little bit different. I don't think it's considered a wild yeast. It says wild ale here on Rate Beer. So we'll see what this one brings. I'm trying to get my palate and my arms around these sour tart beers, but it's definitely an acquired taste, and I have not quite acquired it yet. It's just so tart and sour on a lot of these beers. And I never was a big fan of tart or sour candy as a kid. So I didn't get this big belly from, I like the stuff that's a little sweeter instead of a little sour and tartish. So we'll see what this one brings, guys. This is, like I said, an 8% beer. Food pairings for this beer, cheeses, the peppery Monterey, pepper jack, your more pungent cheeses, and the glassware is a flute, tulip, oversized wine glass. I got the double glass again today, and this can be cellared for extended periods. I don't think it's got anything special written on here that we need to read. And a commercial description on this, it says a Wild Belgian Pale Ale collaboration with Upslope. So pretty straightforward, pretty simple. So let's get the cap off of this bad boy and see if I can make a face for this one like I did yesterday. Nice hiss, a little bit of smoke. Same style of bottle, very unique bottle style. And this one got a heavy sediment in the bottom of the bottle also, so maybe these things continue to ferment. It doesn't say bottle condition, but there is a heavy sediment in yesterday's bottle and in this bottle too. This one is a lot lighter though than the one we had yesterday. It was almost dark like a stout. This one is a rich amber color. Almost like an IPA color. And it's semi-cloudy. I cannot see the bulb. I can see light through it, but I cannot see the bulb. So very good looking beer. 8% or so. It's a little bit on the bigger side than we had the one we had yesterday at 6.8%. Looks very good in the glass, so let's get a nose on it. Definitely getting the Brettanomyces yeast in there. It's got that funkiness going on. Smells very citrusy and fruity. And instead of having the dark berry and sour grape smell to me, it's more like, so it's a lighter fruit smell, like apples or pears or oranges. Got a very citrusy smell, but definitely got the Brettanomyces yeast going on. So let's give it a taste and see what we got and see how sour this one is, guys. Cheers, everybody. Cheers, Nate. Thank you, brother. This one to me is not as sour as yesterday's. got a real nice citrusy taste going on with it. The Brettanomyces yeast is there. It's got that funkiness, but it's a lot on the lighter side than yesterday's beer, as dark as it was. It was just like dark berries and sour grapes to me. This one is dry, just like yesterday's was. But it's got more citrusy, lighter fruit notes instead of the darker fruit notes. This one is not quite as tart, not quite as sour as yesterday's beer. To me, this is a little more drinkable than yesterday's beer for my palate. To me, this is a little more pleasant. But beer taste is subjective, guys. Like, I mean, there's a lot of people, they just love these sour tart beers. And I haven't quite got there yet. But I'm finding this one a little more enjoyable than yesterday's beer. Well, yesterday's beer got a good rating for me because I know it was a well-made beer. We're going to let this one warm up just like we did yesterday and see if it changes any and sip on it for a little while and come back and do the final grade and chug on this one. But this one seems not quite as tart and sour to me. So let's see where it ends up. Hey, guys, I'm back. This one's a little easier to drink for me. Little more lighter fruitiness to it, and not quite as sour as yesterday's, when we had yesterday. Didn't make my mouth pucker up and make all those crazy faces like I did yesterday. This one is a little easier drinking for me personally, so I enjoyed this one a tad bit more. And like I said, according to what the note did, Nate said, it had a February 2014 release. There's nothing written on the bottle anywhere other than that. Volume 1. So nothing on the front label and nothing digitized on the bottle anywhere that I see. So I enjoyed this one pretty well. A little bit more than yesterday's. It was just so sour and so tart. Made me do that funky face. So I found this one a little easier to drink. And I enjoyed this one a tad bit more than I did yesterday's. Let's do the final chug here. Very dry finish. A lot of citrusy, fruity notes on this. Apples, pears, oranges. A lot lighter taste. And not quite as sour as yesterday's and tarty. Tartiness as yesterday's beer did have. So very nice. Alcohol is very, very well hidden. Didn't get any of that in the taste or the smell. I enjoyed this one a tad bit more, guys, than yesterday's. So I'm going to give this one a 9 out of 10. With an 8%er and nothing that's going to degrade this beer. With Volume 1 written on the back of it, you can go to their website and it'll tell you when it was produced. It was only done once. It was a collaboration between Crooked Stave and Upslope. So, kind of would like to have something else other than Volume 1 on the label. But it is what it is. You can sell this beer for many years, being an 8%er, and I don't think there's anything that's going to degrade this beer. It should be just as good a year or two or three down the road than it is today. So, like I said, this one was done in February 2014 release, so I'm sure it's just as tasty now as it was then and what it would be a couple years down the road. So a good candidate for cellaring if you want to pick up multiples and have one and save one for later on. Or if you just want to grab it and throw it in the fridge for a couple years down the road. So very nice. I enjoyed this one a little bit more than yesterday's. So 9 out of 10 for me, guys, on this one. Let's go over to Beer Advocate. Beer Advocate says 89 in the very good range. I think that number is a tad low. If I was putting a numeric rating on this one, it would probably be somewhere between a 95 and a 97. So, very tasty. I enjoyed this one. I'd love to get my hands and my palate wrapped around this style of beer. And the more of these I drink, the better off and the easier it will be to embrace these style of beers. So, all right, let's go over to Rate Beer. Rate Beer says, overall, 95, and that's about where I would put it, somewhere in that area, but only 69 in the style, so I don't understand what the problem is in the style-wise. I think it was a very nice Belgian style. I wasn't getting a whole lot of, with the Brettanomyces yeast, I wouldn't get a whole lot of pineapple or grapefruit or any of that kind of stuff in there. But there was some very nice fruitiness to it with the apples and the pears and the orange citrusiness of it. So very enjoyable for me. I like this one. So like I said, going to try to drink a few more of these and try to get my palate wrapped around the style of beer. Then maybe the more of this style that I drink, the more that I'll appreciate the one we did yesterday. So with that being said, if you've had this one from Crooked Stave, the Ferris Fluxus collaboration between Crooked Stave and Upslope, let me know what you think, guys. And let's take a walk tomorrow together. See what's in the fridge. See you then.